Good day to you all participants joining us from around the world. You are most welcome to our session titled Improving Sanitation in Africa through the Africa Sanitation Policy Guidelines. It is our hope that at the end of this session, participants will, one, be more informed about the ASPG, two, better understand the ASPG and how to use it, three, understand the support available to adopt the ASPG and how to access this support, and four, understand how they can support the process for uptake and use of the ASPG. I am your host, Kitch Bauer, the Sanitation Project Manager, who will be moderating today's session. As you may be aware, the chat function is disabled, but you can send in your comments on the Partable platform where you see the chat button from which you joined this event. We'll do our best to address the questions you send in through Partable chat during the question and answer session. Now and then, ladies and gentlemen, please allow me to welcome the Acting Executive Secretary of AMCAO, Thomas Banda, to officially welcome you to today's event. Good morning, Thomas. Over to you for the welcome remarks.
Good morning, Kitch. And good morning, our distinguished participants. Your Excellency, Carl Herman Gustav Kretschmann, the AMCO President and Minister of Agriculture, Water and Land Reform of the Republic of Namibia. Your Excellency, Engineer Suleiman Adam, the Honorable Minister of Water Resources of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and the AMCO Vice President for the Western Africa. Distinguished panelists, Eric Momani, representing the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, here present. The distinguished panelist, Kerry Ann, representing UNICEF, here present. Honorable ministers of the Governing Council of AMCO, here present. Distinguished members of the AMCO Technical Advisory Committee, here present. AMCO collaborators, partners, and friends, distinguished participants at this year's World Water Week. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me pleasure to welcome you all as AMCO delegates to the Stockholm World Water Week 2021. I must say we are indeed very grateful to have you join the AMCO session despite the many competing sessions we have out there. And in fact, a very awkward time for some parts of the world. As you are already aware, the general theme of this year's World Water Week is building resilience faster. But resilience cannot be built without access to safe sanitation and hygiene. We all know that access to safe sanitation and hygiene are prerequisites for a healthy and productive livelihood. Presently, COVID-19 pandemic has further drawn our attention to the critical role of hand hygiene, and we need to build on this hygiene behavior. Accelerating access to safe sanitation and hygiene is impossible without a strong enabling environment whose foundation are strong policies and strategies. The African Sanitation Policy Guidelines, the ASPG, as we call it, as you already know, has been developed to ensure that our sanitation and hygiene policies and strategies respond to the present and future challenges. This session has been convened with member states and partners to discuss how we can improve sanitation in Africa through the African Sanitation Policy Guidelines, the ASPG. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, having just launched the ASPG 2 months ago, it is important to further dialogue on how we can work together to support our member states to uptake the ASPG and to mobilize resources and build the needed capacity for implementation. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, since the launch of the ASPG in June 2021, AMCO has developed a rollout strategy for the implementation of the ASPG. In this rollout strategy, we have formed the policy coordination platform, created the ASPG demand form, and developed country policy assessment tools and a framework for tracking of progress of the ASPG with clear indicators. I'm sure the presenters will elaborate on this during the session. Ladies and gentlemen, you will agree with me that implementing the ASPG across Africa demands a collective effort. AMCO alone cannot do it. This session is meant to trigger further discussion on how best we can effectively collaborate on the rollout of the ASPG. Distinguished participants, given the panelists assembled for this program, I have no doubt that justice will be done to the topics of the discussion. I'm very confident that at the end of the day, we shall be more informed about the African sanitation policy guidelines, understand the support mechanisms available to adopt the ASPG, and how to access this support. Our partners and collaborators will also understand how they can support the process for the ASPG uptake and the innovative ways of accelerating the mobilization of funding for implementation of sanitation policies. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the more we have many countries uptaking and using the ASPG, the greater our chances of building resilience faster towards achieving the Sustainable Development Goals 2030 and the Africa Agenda 2063, the Africa we want. Distinguished guests, on this note, AMCO looks forward to collaborating with you, our old and prospective partners, to enable us to improve the sustainable environment of the African continent. Once again, I wish to warmly welcome you all to this discussion, and I hereby declare this session duly opened. May God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Thomas, for those remarks. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as you must have heard, we've consistently said that the ASPG was not designed to be kept on the shelves. The Governing Council of AMCA in the General Assembly in February therefore directed the Secretariat to not just coordinate the rollout of the ASPG, but to document, monitor, and report to it, that is the Governing Council and the African sanitation subsector. Therefore, following the directive of the ministers, we have developed a comprehensive rollout strategy with supporting documents to ensure uptake is smooth and the standard set in the guidelines is adhered to. I will now hand you over to my colleague, Comfort Kanchio, Sanitation Project Officer, to give you an overview of the rollout strategy. Over to you, Comfort.
Thank you very much, Keith, for the floor. My name is Comfort Kanchio. Like Keith said, I'm the Sanitation Project Officer, and I'll be presenting the ASPG rollout strategy. Just a second. Can you all see my screen, please? Thank you very much. Again, the title of my presentation this morning is the African Sanitation Policy Guidelines Rollout Strategy. My presentation will follow this format. So first of all, I will talk about the African Ministers Council on Water for those of us who may be hearing about AMCA for the first time. I will then talk briefly about the ASPG, that's the African Sanitation Policy Guidelines, and then the ASPG rollout strategy, what have we put in place following the launch of the ASPG, and then opportunities to get involved. How can stakeholders be involved in the process of the ASPG rollout? Now, the African Ministers Council on Water, AMCA as we call it, was formed in 2002. By the African heads of state with its headquarters in Abuja. It is a delivery mechanism or on Water and Sanitation of the Specialized Technical Committee of the African Union. And our vision is an Africa where there is equitable and sustainable use and management of water resources for poverty alleviation, socioeconomic development, regional cooperation, and environment. AMCAL's mission is to provide political leadership, policy direction, and advocacy in the provision, use, management of water resources for sustainable socioeconomic development and maintenance of the Africa ecosystem. In 2018, AMCAL developed a strategy for the period of 2018 to 2030. Now, the AMCAL strategy has four strategic priorities. And strategic priority two of the AMCAL strategy aims to ensure safely managed sanitation and hygiene. Now, it is in line with the AMCAL strategic priority two that the African sanitation policy guidelines were developed. Now, about the African sanitation policy guidelines, ASPG. The ASPG was developed to guide African government, policy formulators, and implementers on the process and content of an inclusive and comprehensive sanitation policies. The ASPG can be applied to review, revise, and develop new or existing sanitation policies. While AMCAL recognized that there are different aspects of sanitation, talking about environmental sanitation, solid waste management, and all, the ASPG scope is limited to fecal waste and hygiene. For fecal waste, we're referring to human feces, urine, and anal cleansing materials. And for hygiene, we're talking about menstrual blood management and hand washing with soap and water. The ASPG was developed through consultative process across African countries and even globally. And the idea for this was to identify critical gaps in existing sanitation policies that the ASPG would help address towards achieving safely managed sanitation for the continent. A robust review of the sanitation policy was also carried out during the ASPG development, where we had African reviewers to review the policy and ensure that it aligns to, it conforms to continental and global standards. Now, content of the ASPG. The African Sanitation Policy Guideline has four parts. Four parts and 11 chapters. Chapter one talks about the guidelines, scope of the guidelines, and how to apply the guidelines. And chapter two talks about decision-making process, steps to policy review and development. And chapter three contains the core element that the ASPG is prescribing to be included in sanitation and hygiene policies. And in chapter four, you would find policy, developing policy implementation strategy, how to develop an implementation strategy, how this differs from policy, and what should be included in the implementation strategy. The ASPG was launched, as already mentioned, the ASPG was launched in June 2021, and then this document was launched by the AMCAL president. Following the launch of the ASPG, AMCAL has developed different documents that will inform the ASPG rollout, what we call components of the ASPG rollout. As already mentioned, the AMCAL, as ESCO, have given AMCAL, have mandated AMCAL to launch the ASPG to coordinate its implementation and to report progress. So as a way to ensure that this decision is achieved, AMCAL has developed ASPG uptake tracking system. A first step to tracking the ASPG developments or sanitation policy development, AMCAL has developed sanitation policy assessment tool. This sanitation policy assessment tool contains content that are prescribed in the ASPG document. And the idea is to use the sanitation policy assessment tool to assess sanitation policies of the 55 African countries. The results of the sanitation policy assessment will then be displayed on the what we call the ASPG uptake dashboard, so that countries or stakeholders can be able to see at a glance what the sanitation landscape across the continent is about. And this ASPG uptake dashboard will be hosted on the AMCAO website. Next is the policy benchmarking, what we call the Africa Sanitation Policy Index. Now, the findings of the assessment tool will be categorized from 0 to 5, and this is called the Sanitation Policy Index. Sanitation policies will be benchmarked against this index, and based on their conformity to the ASPG, they will be allocated a weighting. So for example, if your sanitation policy, if the sanitation policy index of say a country like Nigeria is 0, it means that will be represented by a red color, and that means that it has 0 or little conformity with the ASPG. And a sanitation policy index that has a rating of 5 will have the color green, and that shows that it is in total conformity with the ASPG. Now, as the monitoring progresses, the sanitation policy that conforms more with the ASPG, the weighting will progressively increase towards achieving number 5, which is the total conformity, and that will be reflected on the ASPG dashboard on the AMCAO website. A country demand form, what we call demand management system, and a critical component of the demand management system is the ASPG demand form. AMCAO has developed this form, and it is currently on the AMCAO website. This form contains a set of questions that countries are expected to respond to complete. First, to show us the commitment, to indicate their commitment to uptake the ASPG, and to show the resources and their readiness to adopt the ASPG to improve their sanitation policies. This form is available on our website, and we encourage member states, countries willing to uptake the ASPG to fill in the form and submit it. Once the form is submitted, AMCAO will get in touch with such country, and then we'll begin the process of adopting the ASPG, following a critical analysis of all responses of the ASPG country demand form. A critical component of the ASPG rollout strategy is what we call the Partner Coordination and Engagement Platform, PCEP. This platform is an umbrella, I would say, of different stakeholders. It brings different stakeholders together, stakeholders willing to implement the ASPG in the countries where they work. Now, this platform, what it does, because we recognize that different stakeholders may be implementing the ASPG across different countries, we need a platform to coordinate these stakeholders, also in line with the decision of the General Assembly. So the idea of this coordination platform is to ensure that every work that different stakeholders are doing across the continent is carried out in a coordinated and uniform manner. The platform will also increase knowledge sharing, and also other newcomers, new members joining the platform will be able to understand what the implementation of the ASPG is about in countries. And it will also serve as a springboard to launching partners that are joining the platform for the first time to be able to understand what is happening and then pick up the process and support countries in implementing the ASPG in the countries where they are present. High-level stakeholder engagement is another critical component of the ASPG rollout. AMCAO intends to engage stakeholders at high level to ensure that the ASPG is not only heard about, but is implemented at various countries. And one of the ways we intend to do this is working closely with the AMCAL ESCO to ensure that the ASPG is endorsed at the Specialized Technical Committee of the African Union, and also that ministers responsible for sanitation across the African continent understands what the ASPG is about and allocate the necessary resources to ensure adequate implementation of the ASPG in their respective countries. Now, without capacity building, it will probably be impossible to achieve this rollout strategy, because countries, member states need to understand what the ASPG is about and then be able to apply it in their context. So because of this, AMCAL is developing what we call the ASPG training manual. And this includes a step-by-step guide that member states need to know, that focal points need to know, stakeholders willing to take up the ASPG need to know, and need to be well equipped to be able to apply the ASPG effectively in their respective countries. Technical backstopping. Another thing that AMCAL is doing under the rollout strategy is to create a database of experts. If you flip through the ASPG document, you would see that it has different critical elements. For example, financing, regulation, monitoring, and all of that. So the idea of the technical backstopping is to get experts that would support policy development in countries, experts that have financing background, experts in regulation, experts in sanitation service systems, so that they would work with partners in country through AMCAL to develop the different sections of the sanitation policy in different countries. And we are building that database right now. Now, there are a number of ways that partners can get involved in the ASPG rollout strategy. For starters, member states need to fill in the country demand form that is available on the AMCAL website. And like I already mentioned it, once you fill the form, we would receive it and then we would reach out. So you visit AMCAL website. This is the link here on the presentation. Just visit AMCAL website and fill the country demand form and we'll get in touch. Donors can also support, you can also support the ASPG implementation directly by funding one of the pillars of the AMCAL rollout strategy, is coordination or monitoring, and will be available to receive your support to implement the ASPG. You can also support countries directly to develop sanitation policy, to develop their sanitation policy, and this should be done through AMCAL. So you reach out to us and let us know the countries you are willing to support, and then we'll get you started with the relevant stakeholders. Individuals can also support and can get involved in the process through technical support, so volunteering your time to support countries to develop their sanitation policies. And organizations or individuals, freelance consultants, can also support the process by joining the policy coordination and engagement platform. A repeat of the ASPG session will happen tomorrow at 6 to 5 p.m. West African time. So we encourage you to join and invite colleagues to do the same. Thank you very much for your attention, and I'm happy to take any questions. Over to you, Mr. Moderator.
Thank you very much, Comfort, for that presentation. We will now take a few questions on the rollout strategy presentation. Do remember to type in your questions in the portable platform so that we can be able to access, we can be able to take them and address them as we go. Just a reminder that you can type in your questions in the portable chat function from where you joined this meeting. We can be able to see and address Okay, there's a question from Naneke Nix. And the question goes, it is essential, it starts with the preamble, it is essential for actual implementation that civil societies are involved. What will AMCA do to support this? I will allow my colleague Comfort to take a shot at this, and then either myself or Tanko will add. Over to you, Comfort.
Thank you very much, Keith, and thank you to the person who asked the question. So you are absolutely right. The role of the CSOs cannot be overemphasized in the ASPG rollout. And AMCA is working closely with ANU. AMCA is working closely with ANU. From the development of the ASPG, they have been involved in the process. And even during the ASPG launch, they were involved in the process. And right now we've had series of meetings with ANU on how they can get involved in the process. So CSOs, just to mention that civil society organizations are not left out in the process. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Comfort. Any other question?
And somebody comment.
Ambassador Kimulu, it's a great pleasure to have you in this session. Please go ahead and ask your question.
You know, I can't miss to comment after having been honored by AMCA to have been one of the task force members.
It was absolutely.
It was a big honor. We enjoyed doing it. And I just want to take this opportunity to congratulate AMCA for recognizing that African countries do not have a clear, updated, enforceable sanitation policy. And now listening to you, to see that you're even having a database of helping people to move on and developing manuals, I just wanted to say congratulations and all the best, and you can be assured of some of us supporting your work. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ma. And we acknowledge the role you have played to ensure that Kenya is also the first country to uptake the ASPG. Thank you very much. Any other question from the Pathable chat platform? We still have room for one more question. You can ask directly from here. You will have an opportunity to speak. Okay, so I've been asked to make some embellishment to the response that Comfort gave. So if you recall, one of the key pillars of this rollout strategy is the partner coordination and engagement platform. And in that partner coordination and engagement platform, there is some kind of a stakeholder analysis to identify each of the critical stakeholders that will have a major role to play in the uptake of the ASPG. As the umbrella organization for civil society organizations across the continent on water and sanitation, ANU is a critical player and stakeholder in the partner coordination and engagement platform. So yes, like Comfort said, we have been working with ANU and we will continue to engage with ANU to ensure the ASPG taken and civil society play a role, even at country level, in each of the countries that uptakes the ASPG. So without any further question from the audience, I will now go ahead to usher us into the panel discussion. Ladies and gentlemen, permit me to quickly introduce you to the panelists for this panel discussion. And permit me to also say at this point that due to time zone constraints, all the interventions for the panel discussion have been recorded and will be played to you. The first panelist on this panel is Honorable Suleiman Adamu. Honorable Suleiman Adamu is the Minister for Water Resources, Federal Republic of Nigeria, and AMCAO Vice President for West Africa. And he will be particularly talking in this panel in his capacity as the Vice President of AMCAO West Africa. He will be talking to us about mobilizing political support for ASPG rollout and adoption. Second on the panel is Mr. Kimanthi Chengo. And Mr. Chengo is the Acting Director of Sanitation Management at the Ministry of Water, Sanitation and Irrigation, Kenya. And Mr. Chengo will be talking to us and giving us highlights on the country level engagements on ASPG adoption. And in his intervention, we will expect to hear about the experience of Kenya as the first country to use the ASPG. Third on the panel, and we are expecting it to join, we're expecting him to join us and present directly, is Eric Momani, who is the Senior Program Officer, Global Policy and Advocacy, Water, Sanitation and Hygiene at the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. And he will be giving us the donor perspective and resource mobilization for the ASPG rollout. And we understand that it will be probably 3 or 2 a.m. in Seattle, Washington State in the United States of America, where the Gates Foundation and Eric are based. So we hope that Eric will be able to join us to present his presentation directly. And last but not the least, the panelists we have is Kelly Anello. And Kelly is the Associate Director of Water, Sanitation and Hygiene at UNICEF. And she will be talking to us about technical support and partnerships for ASPG rollout and adoption, where she will be speaking from the position of the first agency to secure funding to support the uptake of the ASPG, working closely with the AMCAO Secretariat. Honorable ministers, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, I will now start by making presenting to you the recorded intervention of the AMCAO Vice President for West Africa, Honorable Suleiman Adamu. Give me a moment to share my screen, to share the presentation from my screen.
Your Excellencies, Honorable Ministers of the Governing Council, African Union Member States, ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I interact with you today on the African Sanitation Policy Guidelines, ASPG, since the rollout. Let me first take this opportunity to congratulate the Secretariat of the African Ministers' Council on Water, AMCAO, for the successful completion and launch of the ASPG. The importance of sanitation and hygiene for the socioeconomic development of the African continent cannot be overemphasized. Yet, only 21% of the population have access to safely managed sanitation, with 18% still defecating in the open. Also, only 20% of the population have access to basic hand washing facilities with soap and water. The emergence of the COVID-19 pandemic has further compounded the situation, but also brought to fore the importance of safe sanitation and hygiene practices. Overcoming these challenges demands inclusive sanitation and hygiene policy, which is the cornerstone of the enabling environment. The INGO report revealed that some progress has been made on the enabling environment for sanitation and hygiene in Africa, but member states need to accelerate action towards achieving SDG 6.2 targets, and the ASPG provides such guidance for the development, review, and revision of inclusive sanitation policies. The elements of the ASPG are also consistent with the UN Accelerator Framework for achieving the SDGs, which includes financing, capacity development, innovation, governance, and generation of quality data. At the 12th General Assembly meeting in February this year, we mandated the Secretariat to provide the needed support to member states to use the ASPG through this decision, that the GA directs the AMCAO Secretariat to launch, implement, coordinate, uptake, monitor, and report progress on the ASPG uptake. As the AMCAO Vice President for the West Africa region, I was delighted to see the swift approach and dedication of AMCAO and member states at the ASPG launch. While this is laudable, there is still more work to be done, as without implementation, the ASPG will just be another book on the shelf. I believe that with the steadfastness and cooperation of African governments, stakeholders, and donor agencies, the ASPG will achieve the purpose for which it was developed. I'm also delighted to know that following the directive given to the AMCAO Secretariat, it has developed the post-ASPG strategy with clear implementation activities, beginning with an assessment of existing sanitation policies, strategies, and plans of the AU member states. I'm also happy that the Secretariat is also putting in place a system for coordination of partners through the establishment of the Policy Coordination and Engagement Platform to ensure a coordinated process for the uptake, share lessons, and learn from one another. The ASPG framework has been used by the Secretariat to develop a policy benchmarking system for rating sanitation policies across the continent. The Africa Sanitation Policy Index, ASPI, is a welcome development and will help all the countries on the continent to measure how comprehensive and effective their sanitation policies need to be to help them accelerate progress towards achieving national, regional, and global sanitation targets. It is indeed exciting to know that the Secretariat has developed an ASPG uptake tracking system in response to the General Assembly's directive, and I look forward to the progress report at the next General Assembly. To ensure that the ASPG is given the desired prominence at the continental level, from adoption to implementation of the policies, the ASPG has been submitted to be endorsed at the Specialized Technical Committee, STC, of the African Union Commission. It is our desire that the ASPG is endorsed by the heads of state in the upcoming summit during the World Water Forum in March next year in Dakar, Senegal. This will unlock the needed resources for the ASPG uptake and for sanitation improvement across the continent at large. In conclusion, I would like to call on development partners, donors, senior government officials, and the member states to provide AMCAO with the needed financial and technical support to effectively roll out the ASPG towards increasing access to safely managed sanitation and attainment of the INGO and SDGs targets. I understand that some countries are already using the ASPG to improve their sanitation policies, and I urge all leads in sanitation ministries to commit to using this valuable tool to improve the enabling environment for sanitation improvement and fast-track access to sanitation across the continent. Nigeria is still working to use the ASPG to improve its sanitation policy, as we promised during the launch of the ASPG. And as I said earlier, I look forward to receiving updates on the ASPG implementation progress. I thank you all for your attention. Your Excellencies.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the intervention from the AMCAO Vice President for West Africa and the Honorable Minister for Water Resources, Federal Republic of Nigeria. The next intervention is from Kenya, and permit me to share my screen and the video from Mr. Kimanti Chengu.
Good morning, good evening, good afternoon to all the colleagues, and it's a pleasure for me to join you this forum session during the Stock Motor Week to highlight some of the aspects that relate to police formulation in Kenya. I'm Virginia Chengo, the Director of Sanitation Management in Nairobi. The process of the sanitation policy formulation in Kenya was developed because of the constitutional requirement that guarantees reasonable standards of sanitation, and also because of the devolved framework that we have in Kenya, which has mandated the regional and county governments the water and sanitation mandate. We have also subscribed to the SDG framework, and this discussion, this deliberation was addressed comprehensively during a sanitation conference in 2019 in Nairobi, where there was a level government commitment to take the sanitation space to make deliberate efforts to grow and reform the way we are undertaking our service provision to Kenya as far as sanitation is concerned. Currently, we are at a safely managed sanitation access of 27%, which is unsatisfactory for us and for as a government. As required by the Constitution, the process of developing the framework adopted a fairly highly participatory and inclusive approach, including all stakeholders, both from government and from other partners that are involved in this particular space. The aim of the extensive public consultation, which involved about 13 steps, was deemed essential for a number of reasons: creating policy ownership and support, awareness creation, sharing on information and knowledge, sharing learning, identification of priority needs, formulation of policy strategies, and consensus building, among others. Engaging the various categories of stakeholders included relevant ministries, departments, and agencies, both national and county government, and state actors, community groups, consumers, and development partners. And this enabled us to come up with a more inclusive, effective, harmonized, and responsive policy document as information, views, perspectives, experiences, and insights generated were shared by the stakeholders themselves directly during the policy consultation. The main purpose in general was to ensure inclusive and maximum input to the public as diverse stakeholders. Specifically, we aimed to seek public and stakeholder views and input in policy formulation process. We allowed the stakeholders to air their, particularly their vision, issues of concern, and priorities for the design, framing, and content of the policy. We got stakeholder feedback on analysis and policy proposals and strategies, and we enabled the stakeholders to exercise greater responsibility of the various stages of the policy formulation. So it allowed a step-by-step process of learning and collection of views thoughts on this policy formulation. The policy is guided and spearheaded by a steering committee that was constituted from various ministries, relevant ministries, government agencies, and state actors, and community groups. This also included some of the actors in the sanitation space, including the private sector. This particular process went through a national and regional consultation through various workshops, and it was very much guided by the ASPG, the African Sanitation Policy Guidelines. We embraced this process of the guidelines because we thought it was very inclusive, comprehensive, and gave a very fair contents, very fair contents that enabled us to really get the process moving forward. It really helped us a lot in terms of looking at the content of the policy. And it's a very good tool that was confirmed by the participation of the various stakeholders in that process. They thought it was comprehensive enough to address the needs of Kenyans as far as sanitation management is concerned. We have now been able to go through the regional collection of views, second round of validation process, and then a national validation process. What is remaining is for us now to engage the legislative arm of the government and a final round of consultation with the county governments to ensure that we have a sector policy that can be adopted and that can be taken up for implementation. We foresee that in the later quarter of this year, we'll have a policy in place, the Kenyan National Sanitation Management Policy, that will guide the sector to ensure that we address the needs, we regulate the whole value chain, sanitation value chain, and we're able to provide reasonable standards of sanitation to Kenyans as obligated by the Constitution. This, we assure, this we are convinced, has been supported fully by the ASPG as far as giving us the way to go forward. Thank you very much, and I submit our views from Nairobi.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chengu. Asante sana for your interventions on the experiences of using the ASPG. And once again, congratulations for being the first country to use the ASPG. And we look forward to engaging with you in the remaining part of the process of finalizing your sanitation policy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we do not have Mr. Eric Mumanyi with us at the moment. And we will definitely ensure that Eric features in the repeat session tomorrow by 4 p.m. or 1600 hours Abuja time. And on that note, I will play the video from UNICEF for the intervention from Kelly Anelo.
To be part of this session, permit me once again to congratulate AMCAO, Executive Secretary Thomas Banda, Kitch, Bawa, Comfort, and the whole team of partners and sanitation champions who have led the way to this landmark achievement of developing and launching the Sanitation Policy Guidelines, or as we now know, the ASPG. With the successful launch just a few months ago, now it's really time for action to support the rolling out and adoption of these policy guidelines across African countries for transformative and accelerated sanitation delivery. Despite the considerable progress we've made in sanitation coverage in recent years, achieving sanitation for all will still require an ambitious and well-coordinated scale-up. As we know, the world is not on track to achieve SDG 6.2 target. Still, 3.6 billion people lack safely managed sanitation, 1.7 billion lack basic sanitation, and still just around 500 million people are practicing open defecation in 2020. Two-thirds of people who still lack even basic sanitation services lived in rural areas, and nearly half of them live in sub-Saharan Africa. More efforts are required in sub-Saharan Africa to accelerate our progression towards our ambitions to reach these targets of sanitation for all. But overcoming these challenges of access to sanitation services calls for robust and long-term strategies to strengthen partnerships, collaboration that will guarantee and sustain support and mobilization of political leadership and investments to accelerate this sanitation service delivery. From UNICEF's side, We are committed to support AMCAO to provide the necessary technical support for uptake and adoption of the ASPG across Africa. Together with close partners like my colleague Eric from BMGF, we will be supporting AMCAO to roll out the ASPG starting in two countries this year, with an initial focus on leveraging our work with the Joint Monitoring Program to support improved data on sanitation as an entry point for evidence-based policy and planning processes. We hope to provide further support to disseminate the ASPG across Africa through high-level events, webinars, sanitation dialogue to ensure that all countries are supported in strengthening sanitation policies and implementation. UNICEF views the ASPG as a strategic initiative with the potential for Africa's leadership to influence other regions of the world in promoting policy, enabling environment for accelerated sanitation delivery. Accelerating sanitation progress in Africa is going to absolutely require mobilizing our political leaders to prioritize investment and the necessary resources and human resources capacities. UNICEF is willing to partner with AMCAO and other stakeholders as part of the ASPG rollout to galvanize this political leadership and position sanitation as a priority and force of acceleration for progress in Africa. All efforts must be made to support AMCAO and national government on ASPG rollout and adoption through a well-articulated plan and strategy to be developed and implemented under the leadership of AMCAO. I would like to encourage all partners and relevant stakeholders to provide this required support to AMCAO and be part of this exciting and transformational ASPG movement. We need this to create a strong and vibrant policy environment for accelerating progress towards SDG Target 6.2. Together, we can work together to influence political prioritization and mobilize strategic partnerships to unlock new investments for sanitation service delivery across the African continent. While the sanitation challenges in Africa are formidable, we have a real opportunity through the ASPG to rekindle hope and re-energize the sector with innovative approaches for accelerating sanitation progress. Let's join forces for the sanitation transformation in Africa. This will be an incredible boost for the health and well-being of today's children, and an incredible legacy that we can put in place for the benefit of future generations. Thank you very much, and I wish you a fruitful discussion today.
Thank you very much, Kellyanne, and thank you, folks from UNICEF. And on that note, I invite my colleague, Tanko Azika, to say the closing remarks.
Thank you very much for the opportunity to say the closing remarks. We just want to use the opportunity to thank all our panelists and partners who have joined us here. We also want to emphasize that this session will be on tomorrow, and all other questions and comments that we have not been able to deal here will be dealt over there. But like Kelly has mentioned, all hands on deck. The Honorable Minister has also called on all other ministers of the sector to join AMCAO so that together we can uptake the ASPG to improve the sanitation enabling environment of the African continent. Thank you so much for joining us, and we hope you will be there with us tomorrow. Thank you once again.
Thank you very much, Tanku, and thank you all colleagues from around the world for joining us at this time that you should be enjoying your sleep. Do have a wonderful day, and we look forward to having you again tomorrow at 1600 hours Abuja time. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.